before we get deeper into deep learning, let's take a look at some common use cases of machine learning. One common application area is something we already saw in the previous videos, and that's making predictions. Another application area that is very interesting is compressing data, like having big data sets that we reduce in size. Also, a currently very hot topic of machine learning is generating new data, where we create art, audio, videos, and so forth. And lastly, the fourth common application area is learning a series of actions. So this is a broad overview of the four different categories of machine learning. And now let's dive a little bit deeper and see a few concrete examples of each of these different areas. A classic application of making predictions with machine learning is spam classification. As we all use email programs, there's something called a spam filter built in. And this spam filter is usually powered by machine learning, and it makes sure that we don't receive too much spam in our inbox. So how it works is that people who develop this spam filter have a large data set of emails which are labeled as spam and not spam, and then we apply a machine learning classifier to make predictions whether an email is spam or not spam. However, there are many types of prediction problems. Beyond the classic label prediction problem, there's also something called object detection. So here's an example where a machine learning system is used to locate cars, let's say in a video stream or in images. Related to the object detection problem, there's also a coupled problem where we combine object detection with predictions. So here, for example, imagine we have a license plate reader where we first locate the license plate in an image or in a video stream, and then we have a machine learning system that extracts the digits and numbers that make up this license plate. These are just a few examples of where we can use machine learning for making predictions. Let's now take a look at the second application area of machine learning, compressing data. Technology has advanced quite a lot in recent years, and telescopes are now so powerful that they can capture high resolution data that we cannot even save on our hard drives anymore because the sizes of these data sets are just too big nowadays. To deal with these massive data sets nowadays, researchers are developing machine learning techniques to capture interesting patterns in the data or extracting sub-data sets out of these large data sets in order to save them for the analysis later. However, data compression is not only useful for saving large data sets, it's also very useful for exploring large data sets. So here's an example where we have a high-dimensional data set that we projected into two dimensions. To explain this a little bit better with an example, imagine we have this data set where we have handwritten digits. So each handwritten digit is an image here, a 28 by 28 image. So 28 by 28 pixels, 784 pixels in total, and this is something we can't easily, let's say, visualize in a plot anymore. So for this, we can actually use a machine learning approach to project these 784 dimensional images into a two-dimensional subspace. And that's what we are seeing here on the right-hand side. On the left-hand side, we have this image which has 784 pixels or dimensions, and we project it down onto two dimensions, two features. And furthermore, the seven you see, the image of the seven, is projected into one single dot in this 2D scatter plot on the right-hand side. And the remaining dots in this image are essentially other handwritten digits. So in this image, we can see, for example, that all the sevens, all the handwritten digits that correspond to the number seven, are clustering together. And also, other images are shown here, which are forming different clusters. So in this sense, we can think of, or we can use machine learning as a way of reducing the dimensionality of a data set in order to explore this data set. Now let's move on from compressing data to generating new data. What we can see here are images that were created by machine learning. On the left-hand side, we see an image of a person. However, this person does not exist in real life. So this image is completely generated by a machine learning algorithm. And similarly with a cat in the center, this is a cat that does not exist in the real life. It's something that the machine learning algorithm synthesized. Or also on the right-hand side, the apartments are entirely created by machine learning. These apartments are actually not real apartments. They are entirely generated. Beyond just creating images of familiar objects in people, machine learning can also be used in very creative ways nowadays to create art. art. So here we see examples of machine learning where the model created entirely new objects. So this machine learning system works with text inputs where we can say something like an armchair in the shape of an avocado, and it will come up with pretty creative and impressive solutions, as you can see. And this would be one example of how machine learning is used today to generate new data. How is it useful? You can think of it as, for example, creating new data sets, even for training new machine learning algorithms. Yeah, and the fourth and last big category of application areas is learning a series of actions. Yeah, a popular and classic example of that would be teaching a machine learning model how to play chess. So here, this is more challenging than just a simple prediction problem, because here the machine learning model has to really learn how to perform a series of actions and also how to respond to the actions by an opponent. Another application area of this paradigm of learning a series of actions is moving a robot or programming a robot so that it can move around on its own. This is very commonly nowadays used in warehouses where there are robots navigating these complex warehouses and finding, let's say, packages and stocking the shelves and so forth. Yeah, so in this video, we learned the four broad application areas of machine learning: making predictions, compressing data, generating new data, and learning a series of actions. However, since this is such a broad field, we will focus in on the most popular application area of machine learning, and that's making predictions. So making predictions will be the core focus of this course. But before we zoom in into the subfield concerned with making predictions, let's also take a look at the three classic categories of machine learning, because that's also something very useful to have in your tool belt when it comes to the common terminology.